Like the other titles of our record, it's a stupid inside joke. Well, this one actually maybe people will figure it out, but it's this one's more of a riddle. Not quite ready to take the mask off quite yet. It lends to the central theme of the record, if that's any sort of hint.
What is the central theme?
Can't tell you. I'm not saying anything, man. It's to not drink in the morning with the way things are. You know, you have your whole life to write your first record, as they say, right? 3 months to write your second one. But this one, it was cool to take a step back and really let the songs mature a bit. And then also by taking so much time, we'd end up like, I'd end up writing new songs in the process. We'd be like, hell, let's set the drum kit back up and record this one now, you know? So some of those songs ended up making the record. After the second record being so rushed, it was nice to take the opposite approach. There's a God up in the air. Tyler and Bill to play with us. They've been touring with us for quite a while now, and it's their first record with us. And so we finally got to get their songwriting input and their musicianship on this record. And Ryan as well, who's been with us, he was with us for the second record, but we finally are a really cohesive band for the first time in the career of this band. Quiet and calm through the day. Creighton and I are around the Charleston, South Carolina area. Ryan Monroe, who plays keyboards, he's in Columbia, South Carolina, which is about an hour and a half away. Bill, our bass player, is in Atlanta, 4 hours away. Tyler Ramsey is in Asheville. That's about 4 hours away. Yeah, but in different directions, you know what I mean? So it's challenging, but it's also, it keeps it really exciting. Because you never know what you're gonna get. You know, it's cool for songwriting now that you can just like email each other like songs and stuff that you're working on, or you know, you can kind of feel like you're down the road working together. But yeah, it's a little scary when you start a tour and you haven't seen each other in a long time. I bet you get a lot of compliments down there. I don't write well collaboratively or whatever. Like, I have to kind of seclude myself because I'm such a terrible player that I really have to, like, I can't let anyone hear what I'm doing, you know? So. But it's cool, the geography of wherever I end up doing those things always ends up being the main influence on the writing itself. I don't really know where the themes come from, really. The songs just kind of tap you on the shoulder if you're lucky. But it's really, like I said, it's really just the geography. I can't really think of why it lends itself so well to writing sometimes, but just staring out the window and trying to write a song. But yeah, there was a bunch of cops hanging out at the first studio we went to. Like, they were bros with the dude that runs the place. We like showed up and there's like cops in the control room smoking ciggies indoors. Like, what is going on in here, you know? And then the studio didn't really end up working for us. This guy was really good friends with the cops, and we stayed in town to another studio. So we had a feeling that we were going to be followed around, and it turned out they actually ended up being really cool and didn't bother us. But the management were like, get out of Muscle Shoals right now, or you're gonna be there for a long time, you know?